Yeah, buddy. I don't know whether to laugh or cry. How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We are here today in Madison, Wisconsin at Ford's Gym, and we have got a workout I've been really looking forward to because we are doing a workout today with a WWE superstar who I'm very familiar with since he arrived on the main roster in WWE. That's twice I've said WWE. Please give it up for none other than the holy man himself, the holy man, Damian Priest. Get in here, Damon. What's going on?
What's up, buddy?
Was that Scott Hall entrance, was it?
Yeah, a little bit of bad guy, a little bit of bad guy. Yeah, buddy.
First of all, let's start NXT. You had some great success down there, you know, North American champion.
Had some cool stuff
very
down there.
Highly sought after title down there. And then, of course, coming up onto the main roster, you were straight into a program with probably one of the most famous celebrities, famous singers on the planet,
yeah.
Bad Bunny.
Yeah, that was wild. I mean, I remember when they asked me, they're like, so we're gonna pair you with Bad Bunny. And in my head, I was like, you named a wrestler Bad Bunny? Because I had no
idea. Was that your reaction?
Yeah, and I was like, and then Hunter was like, no, like the artist Bad Bunny. I was like, oh, yeah, that makes sense.
Did you know who he was?
Yeah.
I had no clue who Bad Bunny was.
I was raised in the same town that he's from.
No way.
Yeah.
Before I got into WWE, I did a little bit of time in the Monster Factory in New Jersey. So we wrestled each other?
Yeah, we were in a tag match against each other.
Which I have no recollection of. And you know why? Because another great story about Damian is, like, when I first met him, he didn't look anything like he looks right now. What did you weigh, bud?
Oh, man, back then, I think at my heaviest, I was about 365.
Jesus, 365.
With zero gym time.
That's incredible.
Yeah, wild.
So let's talk about this, right? What do you weigh now?
225, 230?
That's like 120 pounds.
You know, it's crazy thinking back now, right? Because it's like, I was a different person. Like, I don't even remember that life almost, you know?
Right.
It's crazy. Yeah, I was just complacent.
Okay.
Surrounded myself with the wrong people, just negative, just people who didn't strive for anything more. You know, but the advice I would always get was, you're doing fine.
Right.
Just, your time will come, you do good, don't change anything. And to me, it's like, well, then I shouldn't do anything.
Right.
You know, and I took that to heart, and I literally did nothing. And I didn't understand why I wasn't getting opportunities and why things just weren't working out for me. One day it just hit me, and it was like, well, why am I waiting for other people to help me with my dream?
Right.
It's, nobody lives for somebody else. You live for yourself, you know, especially when it comes to living for your dream and working for your dream. And then it just, a switch
went off.
Yeah, and I was just like, okay.
Man, I'm excited about this. We got a workout today. I think we're on his shoulders today, right?
Let's do it.
We have a name for this workout for everybody at home?
Sure. All rise for Boulders Day.
Let's go do a bit. Let's talk about this workout we have. This Damian Priest, all rise for the shoulder workout. How are we starting this off?
I like to warm up the muscles, get the blood flowing.
Okay.
Obviously, after 20 years and never one surgery, my knees, my back, and specifically my shoulders, because that's what we're working out, are a little soft these days. When I do it, I have to do lightweight.
Right.
You know, I would have liked to lift heavier if I could, but it's just not worth it at this point. I'd rather maintain,
yep.
Get a good workout in where I know I leave the gym feeling a pump and I could see the results. First thing I do is just simple raise. And then, you know, just windmill it.
Windmill, okay.
10 forward, 10 back, do a few sets of that, just so you start feeling a little warmness in your shoulders, you know?
Right.
And then as you go, usually by the second and third set, I kind of speed it up a little bit, where then you, just to get that blood really flowing.
Okay.
And then we start, I like to say my heavy shoulder workout, the heavy part of the workout, even though it's not really heavy, but it's my heavy.
Yeah.
Just to get that extra, and I start off that way and then go lighter as we go, because obviously your muscles will get sore and they'll get more vulnerable as they go. So I like to get that out of the way first instead of later, where you could cause more injury.
So you hit the heavy stuff first.
Yeah.
And then you hit all the smaller parts of the delt.
Yes.
Okay. That makes a lot of sense, man, to be honest.
Let me just try.
Yeah, yeah, okay. So, Jesus, these feel heavy.
Yeah, okay. There you go. There you go.
How many sets of these do you do?
Usually about three.
Okay.
To start, just like you'll know it. If I still feel cold, like I'm not there yet, I'll do an extra set.
Okay.
But usually I'll know, okay, my shoulders are there. There's blood pumping.
Right.
I'm ready to go now.
Awesome.
And for you, it's almost like your pose, right?
I used to do these in school, but I never really did them at weights. You know, you did the circle thing.
Right, exactly. Well, for us, it gets that blood flowing a little faster with the weight.
Totally agree.
I could feel that. I could feel them warming up. And you could literally feel your shoulders get warm. It's kind of cool. All right.
All right.
Let's lift some weight.
Let's do it. So shoulders, I can feel them, they're warming up, right? So what's the first exercise we're gonna do, Damo?
We're gonna do some shoulder presses here. And we're gonna do high reps. So we'll start off with 20 reps.
Okay.
And then kind of work your way down to about 12. So we'll see how we feel, if you could do more. I usually kind of just wing it when it comes to just how many reps I'm doing. Like in between, I'll start off with 20. But as I'm going, if I feel like I could still do 20, I'll do 20. If I could do 24, I'll do 24. Or if I could do less because I feel it burning, you know, I just listen to the body.
Yeah.
You know, and I just want to get, like, make them feel juicy.
Juicy, man.
Juicy.
You know, juicy. Some juicy, you know what I mean? All right, Damo. Show them how it's done.
You could have did 100.
I don't know if I've done 100, man. I still don't trust you.
What do you mean?
I mean, I'm telling you, you're playing this down too well.
Nah, man.
Played it down too well, Damo.
No. I'm being honest with you.
All right, where we going now?
Now we could have the 25. As we go up in weight, I usually try to like leave a range, a lower range of what the reps we did, but up into this. So like for this instance, this one, I'm gonna go try to make it 15 to 20.
Okay.
And then the next set will probably be like, depending on whatever I do, something to that, you know, at least in that range. I'll just
I feel like that's cool too, man.
Like just to give yourself like a target.
Hmm.
But like I said, I listen to the body anyway.
Yeah, it's important. Bobby Lashley said the same thing.
So there's 15. I feel good. There you go. What do you think? You could have done another 20?
No.
No? No? How does that feel?
I felt stout. What do you want to do?
So let's do five, and then another five.
Good, man.
So we'll do this.
Yeah.
I'm thinking 8 to 12.
Right.
Take off all the weight and then do as many as you can.
We're just at the bar?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Maddie's getting that crotch shot in there. Get that crotch shot in there, man. There you go. Drago! Yeah. How many was that?
Eight
reps.
Now take everything off.
Start that fire. Come on, Damo. Awesome. Hey, spot, you all right?
Nope. All right. Yeah.
Look at that. That's what you call a burnout set right there.
The heaviest barbell ever. You milking that for me? Making it seem like it's harder than it is for me.
I appreciate that.
This is
I would never jeopardize a friendship for that.
World class guy. Hell yeah. Boom. Heaviest bar ever.
Oh, they're burning.
It's just the first exercise.
Yeah. No, you start with this first.
I mean, you could always just get a pint. I'm just saying.
That'd be too easy.
That would be too easy.
You want to do the episode of us drinking Guinness?
Oh, man, but that's a different show.
Okay, Damo, I'm not going to lie. My shoulders are already on fire after all those reps.
Same. But, so, same idea, same mentality when it comes to this. The different change of a grip, plus we're using a machine, kind of stabilizes everything a little bit better.
Okay.
Kind of helps you a little bit and keeps everything even.
Right.
You know, because we all have a dominant side. So this, I like the machines in between doing some free weights just to kind of balance me out.
Okay.
And helps prevent injury.
Great. Great idea.
So we're going to go with the 20 reps and then work down by adding weight. I'm still not too crazy with the weight.
Okay.
But make it so that that lightweight seems really heavy.
This is old school.
This.
I think Jesus worked out on these machines. They're all there. All right, 20 reps, right?
Yep. I just paused on the last one.
So, what I also like about this demo is the fact that, so we're obviously this grip for the bar,
yep.
But now we're using a different grip on the shoulder, so it's hitting.
You're hitting multiple areas of the shoulder.
That's a good way of saying something we don't actually know what you're talking about when the scientific.
Yeah.
Bro
science. Boy. I have no, I don't even know what the muscles are called half the time.
Okay. Lesson one of bro science. Go tell him, Damo.
Do stuff that works all the parts of your stuff. So if you do the same type of workout, you're just gonna work out the same thing. But if you move your hands, it's gotta do something different. Bro science.
Bro science.
Hey, you know how you always see guys at the gym, you know, sparring by themselves? I'm that guy.
Shadow boxing.
Shadow boxing.
20 reps.
Let's do it.
Quick question. What's the most embarrassing song on your playlist?
Oh, most embarrassing song? I can't tell you then.
You have to. It's a moment of truth. Come on, give us a stable.
Give it a name. I'm trying to think. Most embarrassing, because there's probably a few in there.
Come on, it has to be one that you're afraid to tell anyone until this moment in time.
Man, this is brutal, I'm about to say.
Come on, Damo.
There might be a old Britney song, Britney Spears song here and there in my playlist, like a Hit Me Baby One More Time.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. This man knows how to party like it's 1999.
I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm a big Britney fan, so.
Who isn't in our age group? Hit Me Baby One More Time, all right.
Classic. And then Slayer right after.
All right, come on. Oh, baby, baby. Come on. Good, good. Awesome. How many was that?
15.
15 reps. Great.
15 reps?
15 reps.
Jesus, heavy.
There you go. Yeah, buddy. There you go. Yeah. Hell yeah. Oof. That was a 10, boy.
A tenner?
There you go.
Awesome, man. Keep going.
That will do. That's starting.
So this is the drop one.
Yeah. Doesn't look like it's gonna be a 27.
I can drop it down again, man. No harm. Drop it down again.
It still feels so heavy. Yeah, like right here is where it feels heavy.
Yeah, we've been blasting shoulders for the last two sets, man.
Let's do 130 then. We'll see.
See how it feels if not do the 110.
How many did you get in the first one?
So I did 10.
Okay.
I did 10 again.
All right.
Which is funny, like I said, the last set I did, I was able to do 10 with a lighter weight. I added and that's all I can do.
That's because we're stalled. Okay.
I may have been 110. There you go. That's good. That's good.
What was it? 50?
Go to 50. 50. Okay. See, you could do 20. All right. This guy's a machine.
This guy's on a machine.
He's right a machine. Unbelievable.
12.
You gonna get me one of the cool t-shirts or what? Oh yeah. All right.
So we've done all the heavy compound stuff and now we're gonna move on to the small intricate stuff.
Yep.
That's Drew Galloway there. Oh, Drew McIntyre.
Oh.
It's where
it's we got nightmares and psychopaths running around this gym.
It's where we ride together or something. All right, let's go. Let's keep it moving.
We start at our sides. We come up no higher than here. Straight across, straight back, down.
How many are you doing?
I'm going to do between 5 and 8 of those.
Okay.
Then we're going to grab this 45-pound dumbbell and driver.
All right.
Steer the steering wheel, I'll show you.
Okay.
So everything's controlled, so stop. In, out, stop, down. So those. And then we're gonna do 10 of these bad boys. Might maybe a little higher. Yeah.
I wasn't gonna say.
I was like, man, this is really heavy. here we go.
So you switch 45 for 15?
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
It looked bigger.
It is, they always say that. How many on this?
10.
10, okay.
So do the 15, you know, just like I did, just warming up. We'll go up on the next one. There you go. Where'd you learn how to drive?
Here.
Yeah. Not New York.
Florida, though. The easiest place.
I was about to say, not New York.
First, the easiest place to get a driving license. You get six tokens in the back of the back of cornflakes, a cornflakes box, send them in, you get a free license. If we do these together, I can get 15, so we can do them together.
Yeah, let's do it.
Come on, Damo.
One more.
Bus drivers.
Yeah.
Adam drivers. This is heavy.
Yeah.
Have you done this?
As many as you can.
Oh my God.
Eight.
Nine.
Kick out, kick out. It's like someone's lighting a match underneath our shoulders. They're on fire right now. Here we go. One more. Oh, man. You barely even lift them at that point.
I hate these Adam drivers, man.
Go. Yeah, buddy.
I don't know whether to laugh or cry.
Are we doing figure eights with these two?
A little lighter. Probably go to 25. We did the lower stuff.
Right.
Now, when we start, start here.
Yeah.
And then it's.
Look at that mobility.
And then go back.
Look at grace.
And then you start this way. Usually these, about three, and you're good.
Three reps?
Yeah, but it seems like that's it. But by the third one, you're like, I gotta put these down. And then.
Figure eights.
Try to do five figure eights.
So as many reps as you can do, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Sides. Here. Forward. Here. Up. Down to your sides. Forward, back. Straight up from, there you go. Forward. Back to the front, drop. Well, yeah, you got it. There you go. That's three. Another five of those.
I still don't know what I'm doing on the first one.
It's
my body's like, what are you doing?
Yeah, well, you're getting both. You're getting this way and this way up, and you're just not bringing them all the way down. And these bad boys.
Still don't understand what's going on.
Yeah, it's just
but
stuff.
I'm just gonna follow your lead.
Just more stuff to work out other stuff.
Bro science.
Down. Okay. And then here we go. At least five. Or try. Yeah.
My shoulders are blasted, man.
Yeah.
It's great.
One more.
Okay.
There you go.
I lost already.
More time.
I cheated.
It's okay.
I cheated.
All right. I cheated every figure eight, so. That's a wrap. Yeah, there you go.
I don't want to do that. Let me do one.
So here, I like to do the traps, the wider grip instead of straight, although I do them like that from time to time, because usually when they're closer to my body, I feel more strain on my neck. I feel like when they're, my arms are a little wider when I do my traps, it's just focusing on the traps and I can actually feel the muscle moving, opposed to my neck getting stiff or pinching a nerve or something.
Did you go?
Yep, I did 20.
You did 20?
20.
Show up. Alright. Oh my god.
Alright.
Oh my god. This is what I love about these gyms too, different handles.
So you step forward.
Oh, in the middle. Okay.
Make sure they're behind you, and then all traps rise. Look at that sweet shirt.
Got one.
I feel like you and your shirt is doing traps too. There you go. That's good. See? Nips up. He gets it.
Yeah. Nips up.
Nips up.
You got heavier? What are you on?
Just one.
130?
Yeah.
Okay. Dropping the weights, dropping the reps. Maybe not.
I don't think so, yeah.
We'll see how it traps, man. Okay, so you got all the way out. I didn't do that properly, so I'm gonna try that technique as well.
And when they're down, I completely relax my shoulders. Right. This way it's like starting from scratch. Completely relax. Tense.
All rise.
All rise.
All right. Here, right?
Yeah.
I feel that's a lot better.
Yeah, and it's just, it completely relaxed your arms, and it almost feels like you're not really getting your shoulders and traps all the way up. But all you need is a little bit. It's just you just need the muscle to flex while you're lifting the weight. I feel it.
What you got?
I did 20. Gonna keep the same weight. Try to do another 20. Alright. One more set.
What, after this one?
No,
the last one?
Yeah.
The whole thing. Now you're gonna fire us up. We're gonna finish me off.
Let's throw some hands.
Brown bread. I'm gonna be. So what are we doing? Show us what we're doing.
We're gonna do rounds. Basically, we'll round it. So we're gonna start off with simple jab. You know, bam, move over. Boom, move over. Boom. We go all the way around. When you reach your starting point, jab cross.
Okay.
All the way around. Reach your starting point, jab cross. Hook.
Okay.
All the way around.
Right.
Starting point, jab, cross, left hook, right hook. Okay. All the way around. When we're done with that, and especially the hooks, effort. Done with that, then we just do 50 hooks in a row. 50 body hooks. Just boom, 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 boom. 50 in a row.
50 in each arm or 50 in total?
50 each arm.
Jesus.
So 100 total. So I'm gonna go first, do a little round so you can see, and then it's all gonna be all you. I'm just going to town on the bag, all right?
You're
going to
do the whole thing yourself.
I'm going to do the whole thing right now.
And then I'm going to do it.
Sounds good.
All right. Say a prayer for me there, will you?
First part. Now here we go. You want to do that first? Let me do the 50.
Keep going. Yeah, 50. Yeah, keep going. Do the whole thing, Damo.
That was just 50.
50 on each arm.
No, that was just 50 total. We'll do 50 total.
Okay.
Hands up. There you go. Take your time. It's not a speed, it's more of, I hit it with purpose. With purpose. Knock that guy out. There you go. With purpose, hard. Put your might into it. There you go.
I missed that one.
That's all right. Boom, 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 bam. Hands up. Always see your chin after every punch. You release a punch, put it right back to your chin. There you go. With might, all your might. One more. There you go. Twist them hips. Put your hips into that. There you go. Yeah, buddy. Ready to go. All right.
Cement feet.
I feel like right now at this exact moment is my chance. Hey, let's spar.
If you can lift me up and drag me into that ring, I will spar you.
Come on, you don't need me to pick you up. Let's go.
Damo, come over here, you mama. That was awesome, man. I appreciate that, man.
Hell yeah. Good work.
So much.
That was fun.
That was such a unique finisher for shoulders. This was great, mate. Like, look, you know, we didn't go heavy. We did a lot of reps. We lowered the weight. We lowered the reps by adding the weight. It was great shoulder workout. Your story is so inspirational, man. Everything you've been through, dropping over 120 pounds to follow your dream. And now the reward here of you being in WWE and being so successful as well.
Crazy.
In such a short number of years. The other thing as well about it is that, like, yeah, you got here later, but I'm sure that just is even more satisfying. The fact it took so long to get here.
Oh, yeah.
The reward. It felt even more fulfilling.
Yes, I agree with you.
You know what I mean?
I agree with you. Zero regrets. And if my story can help just one person, it'd mean the world to me. I'm Damian Priest.
This is Sheamus.
We do stuff to different parts of your stuff. And that's
bro science.